What is up, everybody? Kingslayer KDKF back here today, and for this video, I'm going to be doing my top five favorite controllers. But these are the ones I have played with. I'm not including ones that I have not played with, or ones that are very old, or ones that are very new, which I haven't played with. But they will be for us. Old gen and new gen controllers from the 2000s, so the 21st century. I will not be including anything in the 19th or the 20th century or anything for computer. So let's get right into it with number one. So my number one favorite controller is for the Xbox One. I prefer the Xbox One controllers because they fit my hand good. Like, the bigger these controllers, they just feel better in my hands, is what I'm trying to say. The first controller I ever played with on Xbox One was, not this one, I don't want to get too specific and have to look through everything. So it was this one, but in the blue, navy camo. As you can see, it's got all those, it's just got the camo, same format as the original Xbox One controller. If you get to the bottom, it does not have the audio jack right here. It is just one of the original Xbox One controller jacks with the chip, microchip, and two 1.5 millimeter audio jacks on each side. And for the top, it does have the USB hookup. Okay, for number two, we are going to be at the Xbox 360 controller. I like the Xbox 360 controller for the same exact reasons as the Xbox One, but this is the first console I ever played. The first controller I ever used was this one. Now, a lot of people know this one, but it is the 2.5, I believe, audio jack right here in the middle, and it has the double chip on each side. And for that, it does not have a USB. It has, I forgot the name of the type of cord that goes to the top, some type of jack, and then it has the displaceable battery pack on the back, which can come off just by the click of the button. Okay, so yeah, and it is in the same format as the Xbox One. It's just a little bit smaller of a controller, and it is also a lot heavier. It also has that button right here, which is not like just the tap. It is the rounded Xbox button. Okay, so for number three, I have the DualShock 4 PlayStation 4 controller. This controller is actually if I had to choose between the Xbox 360 and the PlayStation 4, I'd probably choose the DualShock. But I like this one because it comes in all different varieties, and it has that touchpad. Now, this is the first one I ever played with right here. It is the military camo again, and it is, I like the format of the whatever you call these. I think they're, I don't care. Yeah, I like the format of these, and the pad right here helps a lot because when I'm trying to, like, type and I don't want to use the left joystick, okay, there it goes, it helps a lot. But one thing I dislike about this controller is the buttons. Now, on the Xbox, they have that classic X, Y, A, B, but on the PlayStation, they have the square, triangle, X, and circle. I mean, I know it's the same exact thing, but I just like to know that, like, when my brother tells me to press X, I always press square, and this is X, but I guess it's not that big of a deal. For this controller, they have the classic hookup. I'm pretty sure that's what they had on the... No, wait, that's like a USB kind of, and it's some type of chip, but, and they have the 3.5 audio jack, and on the top they have the USB hookup, I believe, right below here, and the microphone is on the front. Unlike on the Xbox controller, it does not have a microphone. Yeah, so number three. Coming in at number two, we have the, I don't really know the name, the DualShock 2, okay, the DualShock 2. This is for the PlayStation 2. I haven't played PlayStation that much, PlayStation 2 that much, but if I had to choose, yes, again, I would go for PlayStation at number 4. I like the PlayStation 2. But I like the PlayStation 2 controller for the same exact reasons, but another dislike, that gamepad, the pad right here, that really helped a lot on the PlayStation 4. Again, the button layout right here, that doesn't really like me. But one thing I like about this is the arrows, those help a lot. The joysticks are in a different position from the Xbox, which makes it easier to reach to. And up in the bumpers, those are a little farther away, so that is one more dislike. But otherwise, it has a good shot at being number one. Okay, up top we have sometimes the charging dock, or you can make it wireless or wired controller. If you don't want to charge it at all and you just want to play free, yeah. So you got that. And last but not least, this is my least favorite controller, but if I have to put it in the top five, this is the fifth place. It is the Nintendo Wii remote. I used to play Call of Duty World at War on the Wii, and that was the original game that I think I ever started playing for Wii, actually. Yeah, my uncle gave me it a while back, I'm pretty sure. And let's pick a picture. Okay. What I like about this is, I don't know, it was better. Okay, nunchuck. Get that nunchuck in there. Yeah, so sometimes this controller came in use. Like, in Call of Duty, you could attach it to the gun and stuff. And see if they have a picture of that. They have, like, this gun that it attaches to. It wasn't for Call of Duty, but they have it anyways. See, they have all these attachments. Oh, there it is. Okay, this was my favorite thing for the game. Like, you could just take it, and you could act like you're walking around and stuff. But you, like, take that right there. You take the nunchuck, you put it right here, and that joystick and the firing, that just, like, was perfect for me. And then that Y button was right here. That helped a lot too. I liked this controller because, like, it, unlike the Xbox and the PlayStation, it actually, like, you could put it in different forms, like a gun. They had the actual controller. They even had a controller for it. Let's see if I can find another one. Seems like they do not have another one, but that's okay. Yeah, they have the nunchuck, that helped a lot, but again, with the Wii, the only game I really ever played on it was Call of Duty World at War, and that was the first game I ever started playing on the Wii, or my favorite game I ever played. I defeated that in all modes. So, if you take this controller, they have the battery pack inside of the controller. It is on the bottom. They have a vibrate added on, just like Xbox and PlayStation. The microphone is on the front, so sometimes you can hear noises coming out of that. It shows you, like, the player number, just like Xbox 360. They have number 1, 2, 3, and 4. You could go up to 4. On the bottom, they had the hookup for the nunchuck, and I'm pretty sure they had one other attachment. And then there was this right here, these two things right here, these little hookups. There was this game called Wii Resort, and if you got that game, they had the, like, a cube. I don't know if they show it on here, but it was like an extension for it, and you could do, it was just like add-ons to the controller for, like, yeah, right there. These things right. Nope, that's the front. Okay, never mind. So they had those add-ons. Kind of looked like that. and it did the same thing. It just added a few games from the, or added a few things from the game. But otherwise, this, oh yeah, and the sensors right there for the Wii bar, which was kind of like my camera up there. But yeah, otherwise, this would be my least favorite. So, number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. I hope you guys all have a good day. I will try and get another video in after this because I am trying to get as many videos up because I have been absent for who knows how many days on this YouTube channel. Once again, love you guys. Oh yeah, forgot about this. I made a fidget. It's just duct tape and 3 bearings, but whatever. Okay, see y'all later. Peace. See you in the next video.